What's up guys, Alex here, GuitarForest.com. So in today's video I'm going to show you an excerpt from the lesson on how to play a song called Taboo by Santana. And this was requested and supported by Bruce Cheney, so huge thanks goes out to him for the support. And like I said, this is just an excerpt from the lesson. The full lesson is available at GuitarForest.com. You can find the link in the description box down below. And with the full download, you're going to be getting the video lesson, obviously, and all the necessary tabs in PDF format. Unfortunately, I couldn't find or make a backing track for this song, so there is no backing track or playthrough, but all of the parts are being played in the lesson. Slowed down, and you know, I've broken down into sections so you can see and hear all of the parts being played through in the lesson. In this song we have two different guitar parts. So one guitar is playing sort of a rhythm guitar and the second is a lead. So all of that is broken down in a full lesson. In today's video I'm going to show you just the first part of the rhythm guitar for this song. And for the sound, I was using the VST plugin Guitar Rig with two different presets. One is a little bit cleaner for rhythm guitar, and the second is overdriven guitar for the lead guitar. And I'm going to show you the pictures of the presets right now. We're going to be in standard tuning. So while you're checking out the pictures of the presets, here is my low E string, so you can tune up and play along with this lesson. So as usual, we're going to break up the song into parts, and we're also going to break it up into rhythm guitar and lead guitar because there are two guitars going on there in the song. And we're first going to take a look at the rhythm guitar parts, and then we're going to move on to the lead guitar. Also another thing, the rhythm guitar is playing on a little bit cleaner sound with a little bit of a chorus on it, and the lead is using more overdrive, so just keep that in mind. All right, so we got that out of the way, so now let's break it up into parts. We're gonna start with the intro part. So the rhythm guitar is playing the following intro. So that's the first part, pretty straightforward, nothing too complicated here. So it starts off with just single notes here. We have, so 7th fret on the A string, then we go to the 5th on the D, then we have a slide on the same string into the 9th fret, so. And here we're going to be staying on some of the notes a little bit longer. It's a kind of free form here, staying on these notes. So that's the first three notes. Then we have 7 again on the A, then go to the D, 5, 7, back to 5, back to the A, 7, 5th fret on the A string, and then we have the first chord, the E minor, and we let it ring out. Then the second part of this intro we have, so again the first three notes, but instead of going to the 9th fret we have the 7th fret on the D string, and again we stay on this note a little bit longer. And then the last part we have, so as we stay on the 7th fret on the D string, we then hammer on a grace note from the 5th fret, slide into the 9, back to 7, back to 5, onto the A string 7, to the 5th fret. So that's the second part of the intro. So one more time, the whole intro rhythm guitar part goes like this. Thank you. All right, so that was the intro part for the rhythm guitar. Then we go into a section which is being played before the verse, sort of like an interlude, and it's just the rhythm guitar is just playing the chords. So two chords we have here. So this one is like an E minor add 9 chord. And then we go to the E minor add 6 or 13, if you will. So we just play between these two chords. Each of the chords is being played for the whole bar, and we do it for two times each of the chords. So. Alright, so that was the interlude, and then we go into the first verse. So the rhythm guitar just starts off with a low E string open for the whole bar, and then just keep in mind that there is also the lead guitar is doing something similar, so just keep that in mind. But then the lead guitar is going completely different, doing completely different things, adding some fills and stuff like that. So the rhythm guitar starts off with the low E string open for the whole bar, then again one more time the low E open for the whole bar, and then we go into this riff, which is all right. So I'm gonna explain the chord progression first, and also the riffs that we're playing during the chord progression, and then I'm just gonna point out, kind of play through, because the fills are repeating themselves. We have about 3-4 different variations which I'm gonna point out, but the main idea of the song for the rhythm guitar is just that we play in E minor. The chord progression goes like this: E minor for 4 bars, then we go to A minor for 2 bars, back to E minor again, and then for the turnaround we have B minor 7, C, D, back to E minor. Okay, finish off the chord progression like that, and then we start the same thing, the same cycle over and over again. So that's the chord progression, and now getting into the riffs. So like I said, the first two bars we have in E minor, just playing the low E string open. One more time. And then we go into this riff, which is... So here what we do, we kind of break up the chord into parts. So we play the low E string first, then we play the next part of the chord, and then with an upstroke we play just open strings. So we have, and then we have this lick, which is on the G string, bending the second fret up, bring it down, pull off, and then do the pull off on the D string as well, 2-2 open. So that's the riff pretty much, and it repeats itself. There is slightly different rhythmical patterns here, but pretty much that's the bulk of the riff. So after that we go into A minor 7, so we have, so that's what we do in A minor 7. So you can play the chord here. So the first time we hit it, let it ring out for 3 beats, and then we have just adding a couple of hammer-ons pull-offs. So the first hammer-on pull-off is going to be on the B string, 1-3-1, and then pull-off on the D string, on the G string, I'm sorry, 2-2 open. So like that, and then we play the chord again, let it ring out for 2 beats, and then we have, so here we have grace notes, quick hammer-on from open to the second string, to the second frets on the G string, 3 times, and then we have, so open G, second fret on the D, and then we are back to the E minor chord. So, All right. So I'm not going to be explaining these parts again in the when we move on to the next part of the song, because they're pretty much the same. Where we have the differences, the variations, I'm going to point it out. But that's pretty much what we do during the verses. So then after the A minor, and another thing, just to mention a quick side note, instead of playing the A minor 7 here, you can obviously play it here. And then for the hammer-ons pull-offs, you're going to be using these strings. So G, 5-7-5, and then pull-off, 7-5 on the D, like that. And then for the second part, so the hammer-ons, the grace notes are going to be on the D string, 5-7. And then back to the fifth on the D, 7 on A, and then we're back to the E minor chord. Alright, so that's just a variation that you can use instead of playing these parts here. Alright, so back to the E minor for two bars, we have again the same riff. Now for the turnaround, like I said, we have a B minor 7 chord, so we have... So it's a specific kind of rhythm here that we play, so... Then we go to the C chord. So on the C chord, again, a rhythmical figure, quarter note, followed by 4/16th notes. And then we move on to the D, again, quarter note. And here we have a little lick staying on the D chord, and just using the pull-off here on the high E string. Then picking the rest of the chord. It's more of a, like a triad playing. Okay, so for the turnaround, B minor 7, and again, you can play it here, you can play the C here, the D here, but because of the of that little adding, you know, it's better to move, to use these shapes of the chords. The B minor 7, you can also use it here. Then the C and then the D. Back to E minor. Alright, so that was the first round of the verse. So in the end of the first round, we have the E minor again playing the riff. Alright, so here at the last bar that we have of the first round, we have a slightly different rhythmical pattern here. So we have... So again, playing the first part as we were playing before, so low E string open, then the rest of the chord, and then we have this lick. So just picking the second fret, the G string on the second fret, picking it, then picking again, bend it up, bring it down, pull off to the open string, and then play pull off again, second to the open string, second to the open fret. And then second fret on the D. So. Okay, so that's the one we played the last time of the first round of the first verse. Alright guys, so that was it for this part. I hope you liked it. If you did like it, please give it a thumbs up. If you would like to continue learning the entire song, check out the link in the description box down below. Thank you very much for watching. Comment, share, subscribe if you are new to my channel. Don't forget to visit guitarforest.com for more guitar lessons. In the meantime, I'll see you again. Take it easy, and as always, let the forest be with you.